Hey everyone, welcome to Privy Masterclass. Today I'll teach you all about welcome pop-ups and why they are the essential first step in running your online business with Privy. A welcome pop-up is a form that will load onto your site when you tell it to. And the idea is that you will capture their email address so that you can communicate to them long after they've been on your site. So what makes a great one? Let's dive in and make one together in Privy. Now for this example, what we're gonna do is we're going to create a welcome pop-up that offers them a discount on their next order if they provide their email address or their phone number. So in my Privy account, the first thing I wanna do is actually create a coupon that we can use in the pop-up. So we'll click on the coupons tab, then we'll click on new coupon on the right. Next, we'll select a title for our coupon. This is just for internal use, so you can name it whatever you'd like. Next, I'll choose the source for my coupon, and since I'm connected to Shopify, I'll choose Shopify. And for this type of coupon, you can actually choose master or unique. Now for this instance, master is the perfect way to go. You can use one simple coupon for everyone that loads onto your site. We'll talk about unique coupons later when we talk about expiring or Black Friday coupons and things like that. Scrolling down, let's type in the actual code we'd like to be our coupon code. We'll choose the discount type, and I'll set that at 10%. We'll make it so it applies to all products. We'll have it start today. We will not have it expire, and we'll click Save Coupon. Once you're finished with the coupon, go ahead and click on the Convert tab and click All Campaigns. The Convert tab is where you'll build all the features that allow you to convert visitors to subscribers, mainly using pop-ups. So as you can see, I've got a lot created here, but we're gonna click on New Campaign, and you'll see a bunch of different options here for you. You can build your own if you'd like, but we already have so many built for you that you can use as a starting point. So for our welcome discount pop-up, we're going to click Create, choose the coupon we just created, and click Continue. Next, you'll see a pop-up that was created for us, and we don't have to change much. One of the tips I'd like to give you right now is in your first welcome pop-up, keep it simple. Don't try to do too much. In this case, published is better than perfect. So use what we give you, tweak it slightly to fit your brand, and make it live. For this one, I'll change some of the verbiage. So I'll change join us to the actual discount amount. And as you can see now, it's a little too big for the box. So what you can do is drag the box this way and move it back to the center and up a little bit. And even though this one's cut off a little bit, you can just hover over it, click and drag lower. You can also change this text by clicking on it too. So we'll say get 10% off your next order when you sign up below. Next, we've got our form field, our subscribe button, and an image. Now for subscribe, when you're offering a discount, I really like to say reveal now or claim offer or something, something that tells them that they're gonna get the code immediately. So you can click on the button, scroll down, and change the text. And lastly, this image is wonderful, but it doesn't really match my brand. So changing it is as easy as clicking on it, clicking choose image, selecting one from your computer, and choosing one that fits your brand. I sell astronaut trading cards, so I'm gonna choose an astronaut. I'll scroll down and click use this photo. And just like that, I have a perfectly branded welcome pop-up. The messaging is clear. They're going to get 10% off when they sign up below, and they can get their code immediately. So I'm gonna go ahead and click save, and it automatically brings us to the follow-up stage, but I wanna point out a couple things to you real quick. I'll go back to the create tab. I'll scroll down, and this pop-up design is what we just edited. So if you wanna go back to it, you can click there. We also have a tab design and a thank you page design. Let's hop into the tab design real quick. The tab is what you see here on the left. Now, this is a really great idea. Remember that analogy I told you about going to a bar to find your mate? Well, what if you asked someone for their number and they said no, and then you just left the bar? What if they changed their mind and now they're looking for you and they wanna give you their number? The same goes for your online store. If someone clicks the X out of this pop-up, what if they look through your site, they like what they see, and they change their mind and they're like, hey, I might wanna buy something, I wish I had a discount. This tab will remind them that the discount is still available for them. So this is a great thing to have on your site to bring people back to give you their email address. So you have different styles that you can choose, you have different colors and texts, and you just wanna make sure that this matches your offer. Then When you're finished, click save. And the last thing I want to show you here in the Create tab is called the thank you page design. Now, after sign up action is telling us what happens as soon as they click the submit or the reveal now button. Right now it says it's showing a thank you page, which is a great thing to have. So when you click into it, you can actually customize everything about this. You can click on the social icons and take those out if you want. You can click on the background and change the confetti if you'd like to as well. So all of this is customizable. You can make this discount code a little bigger if you'd like. So there are a lot of things you can do here. We recommend that you come in here and just make sure it matches your brand. If you don't love the confetti, you don't have to have it. So come in here, make sure it matches, then click save. Perfect. Next, we'll move on to targeting. Click on the target icon on the top. And there are three aspects we really want to look at here. The first is when to show this pop-up. Now, we recommend that you show it anywhere from 5 to 15 seconds once the site has been loaded for the visitor, but this can change for everyone. If you're noticing that a lot of people spend a lot of time on your website, by all means, you could make that closer to 15 seconds. But if for some reason people just aren't spending a lot of time there, you really want to catch them before they leave. So you can change this to 5 seconds if you'd like. Another thing we like to do is setting it so that it'll show after someone has scrolled 50 or 75% down the page. Just make sure for this part that you choose an amount of time or a percentage down the page, not both. You'll also see something for exit intent here. That's for a different pop-up, so we'll cover that later. And you want it to trigger every day if somebody still hasn't signed up for it. So we'll click save. Next, we'll see who to show it to. This is telling us that it's only going to show to people whose device is desktop, so not an iPhone or a mobile device, and if they have not signed up for any campaign yet. And there's a specific reason why we do that, and I'll go over it right after we're done with this when we go over the mobile pop-up. We'll click save here. And how long to show it. We're not gonna have this expire. This isn't tied to Christmas or Black Friday. We want this to go until we stop it manually. So then we'll click next step. And we have an option here for an after signup email or a follow-up email. Now, these are really good ideas for a couple of reasons. One, it fulfills the promise. It wraps up that signup experience. You told them they get a code. Sure, they saw it in the thank you page, but now they know that you're going to be emailing them and they know what to expect from you. So you can click on the subject line. And while it starts off pretty bare, you can choose some templates up here if you want, or you can just edit this one. For instance, this logo that I put in doesn't really match. It's a little too big. So I can click on it, change the width, bring it down a little bit. And maybe I want some additional branding or a different image or something to liven this email up a little bit. You can do that easily by going over here on the left, grabbing an image and dragging it where you'd like to live on the email. Then just click on it. Click upload image and choose one from your computer. This isn't necessarily a best practice. This is just an image I had on my computer, but I think you get the idea. Then if you scroll down, you'll notice that this email is very, very simple. It says, thank you for signing up for blank. This will of course automatically put in your business name. We are thrilled that you're here to use your discount. Just copy the code below and enter it at checkout. And then we use here what's called a liquid variable, similar to business name. Basically, this will just automatically populate whichever signup code is attached to this pop-up. So it'll automatically put the welcome 10 code in here, and then it'll sign off. We want to keep these super simple. We want someone to read it, not feel too intimidated when they open it, and we want that signup code to be really obvious. Another great tip for these emails is to have it come from an actual person. So don't be afraid to sign your name at the bottom of these emails. So once you're done customizing, click save. And as soon as you click publish, this will be live on your site. Now, there is one caveat to this. Remember when I told you earlier that it's only going to be for desktop or laptop computers? That's because this specific pop-up would take up a lot of space on a mobile device. And frankly, when Google scrubs your site and sees these pages where a pop-up takes up most of it, they don't really like it that much. So we've created an optimized experience just for mobile viewers. So to create one of those, we'll actually create a separate pop-up. We'll click on convert, click all campaigns. We'll click new campaign again. Then under mobile signup discount, we'll click create, choose our coupon, click continue, and we'll do the same exact process we just did. As you can see, this pop-up is a little different. It's not a pop-up where it comes in the center of the screen and is pretty big. This just scrolls up from the bottom of the screen. You'll see if I click on the mobile preview, that it just covers half the screen, which is exactly what you want for mobile. Now, the reason why we don't do this on a desktop is because it doesn't really take up enough space to grab their attention. So we'll use this. All you have to do is customize it just like you did before. Click save, change what you'd like the thank you page design to be, move to target, make sure that these are exactly the way you want them. Maybe they're the same as the other pop-up you just created. And in the follow-up section, just recreate the email you just created for your last campaign. Then once you click publish, all laptop, desktop, and mobile users will be given this pop-up when they load onto your site. And that's all there is to it. Now, when a new visitor loads your site, they'll be prompted with your new welcome pop-up with a chance to join your list. Thanks for watching Privy Masterclass, and we'll see you later.